We are going to discuss chapter 3, part 1 in the story Little Princess. As you see, Becky and Sarah are sitting on a bed. Of course, it's not Sarah's room. It's the servant's room, like what Miss Manchin told Sarah to do. Okay, now she is a servant. Look at her face. She's very sad, and Becky too was sad for Sarah. And let's see what's happening. That evening in the little attic, as I told you when I started the story, okay, the window is not a normal window. It's the window for the attic room. This is the attic room. The attic room, you can find it on the roof, upstairs. Okay, so this is the attic, a small room upstairs in the roof. Okay, so that evening in the little attic room, Sarah sat on the bed in her old black dress. She didn't cry, but her face was white and she didn't speak for hours from sadness. Late at night, the door opened quietly and Becky looked in. Her eyes were red from crying. Becky was so sad for Sarah. "Oh, miss," she said, "all the servants are talking about it. I'm so sorry, so sorry." She looked at Sarah's white face and began to cry again. Then she ran to Sarah and took her hand. At last, Sarah slowly turned her head and looked at Becky. "Oh, Becky," she said, and that was all she said. The first night in the attic was very long. Sarah didn't sleep. "Father is dead," she whispered. She whispered means she talked or she was speaking quietly. Okay? Again and again. "Father is dead. I'm never going to see him again." She was so sad. Poor Sarah. The next morning, Sarah's new life started. She learned to clean the floors and to make fires, just like Becky. Do you remember when we said, what does Becky do every day? Now, Sarah is a servant just like Becky, and she learned to clean the floors, to make the fires, and she ran upstairs and downstairs. She worked in the kitchen too. The cook, okay, is the man who cooks. Okay, now we have it a woman. The cook was a big woman with a red, angry face. So, she said, "The little rich girl with the diamond mines is now a servant." She looked at Sarah. "Now I'm making apple pies. Yes, she's making this apple pies. Okay, and she needs some apples. Run down to the shops to get me some apples. And be quickly. Now she orders, or she's giving Sarah orders. So Sarah ran to the shops and carried a big bag of apples back to the house. Then she cleaned the kitchen floor and carried hot water up to all the bedrooms. She worked every day from early in the morning to late at night. She helped in the school too. "You speak French well," said Miss Manchin to her coldly, without feeling. "So you can teach French to the younger children, but you are only a servant." Yani she didn't let her be a teacher to learn French. "No, you are only a servant, but because you can teach, you can speak English well, you can teach the younger children French. Don't forget that you are just a servant." The first month of Sarah's new life were very hard. She was always tired and hungry, but she never cried. At night in her little attic, she thought about her father, that in India, and all those miles away. He was too far. "I must be brave," she said to herself. "Father always wanted me to be brave, and I have got a bed to sleep in and something to eat every day. Lots of people haven't got any or haven't got that." So she tried to let her to feel satisfied of what she had. She had a bed, she had something to eat, and that's all. At first, Sarah's only friend was Becky. Every day, Becky came into Sarah's room. They didn't talk much, but it helped Sarah a lot to see Becky's friendly, smiling face. The girls in the school were sorry for Sarah. All the girls in the school were sorry for Sarah and what happened to her. But Sarah was a servant now, and they couldn't be friendly with her. Lavinia, of course, was happy. all the school was sad except Lavinia. She was the only one that is happy for what happened to Sarah. Okay? I never liked Sarah Crew, she said. She told her friends, and I was right about the diamond. There weren't any. Now she is happy that Sarah became a burger. And that's all for chapter 3, part 1. See you inshallah next chapter. Thank you for listening.